have a chance to say, there is so much to talk about, but I remember when the San Diego health officer and he were dialoguing early on in Right Care San Diego, that if you take your proven clinical protocols and you put them, you empower the pharmacists that are out in the community. They're out in the community and they're interacting with patients every day. It's something that could have probably saved my mother's life, because she was out there going to the groceries, going to the pharmacies on behalf of her children and family. And so getting it out into the community, I think, is just a critical thing that the health systems of Sacramento should be collaborating on. We shouldn't be expecting everybody to volunteer to do it. It benefits the whole community to reach out. So in our LA University Best Practices, a couple of weeks ago, we had the firefighters with us in LA. It turns out the firefighters in LA are working with UCLA. They've been proactively screening their firefighters for the heart CT scan, and they've lowered their events dramatically. They're saving $1.5 million a year just on their firefighters, and the firefighters are willing to go out and sit in front of the grocery stores and take the blood pressures and bring that screening out into the community. So we can learn from the other communities and be more proactive with ours, but one of the things we could really use the help of the health system in doing is connecting the community benefits people to say, let's work together on this, instead of having these little, a constellation of uncoordinated efforts.
So Hattie, you know, we are offering, what we're doing is we're incentivizing the people who come. So we're giving them to finish their HbA1c's $50.
That's beautiful.
For members. That's about that. We're giving them for cervical cancer, for blood pressure, we're implementing a $25 incentive where they go into the provider, get their blood pressure done, they're going to get $25. So, I mean, it's those kinds of things.
Is that just your Medi-Cal population?
Medi-Cal population.
Medi-Cal population only.
Yeah.
So we have with us the Armed Services Medical Group with us today. They didn't introduce themselves, but it'll be good to hear their incentives too.
So we wanted to thank you all on our fifth anniversary again for coming and thank our speakers. Dr. Damari is gone, but see you next month.
And a special thanks to Shannon Dornbrock for telling her story of why we're all here.